to be able to show the functions of the other tools, like mirror tools, let us draw a shape which has difference in symmetry axis, that is to say antisymmetric according to x and y directions, to be able to see the functions of these tools clearly. Yes, we have done something like that, and we select all of this. When we select this, you will see mirror vertically. When you mirror this vertically, there is a vertical axis passing through the middle of, passing through the center of this shape, this axis coming from top to bottom. And when we click on vertical mirror, the shape is mirrored according to, with respect to that axis. When we click on mirror horizontally, then this shape is mirrored according with respect to an axis that passes through the center of this shape again, but horizontally. To see the effect of added node function, let us draw two lines which do not intersect and click on the empty space by pick and then select added node. Bring the mouse on the end of, for example, the first line. You will see some sign like this, like a compass sign. This, when you see this, click on left mouse button and then click on left mouse button again and pull it. If you click it once, you cannot. You will click it two times and you won't leave the second click of the left mouse button and carry it until where you want to intersect. If you want to intersect to this end, pull it until this end. You see, again, the same sign occurs when it intersects, or carry it to here and leave it in here. Leave the left mouse button in here. When you leave it, it is not finished. You have to click it on the left mouse button once more without moving it. The sign must be on the intersecting point. So, when you select pick and click on empty space, you will see that these two lines intersected perfectly. Without doing this, you cannot be sure some ends, whether they are intersected or not. So this is a helpful tool. Let us come to our famous sizing tool. To show the functions of sizing tool, let us draw a rectangle. When this rectangle is selected, it must be selected, because if you don't select, if you click on empty space, then you will not be able to use the size function, size tool. First, select the rectangle or anything you draw and then click on size. You will see length on x-axis and length on y-axis. The length on x-axis is the width of the rectangle, since it's a rectangle, and the length on y-axis is the height of the rectangle. You can give any value you like. For example, let us make the height, the y-axis dimension, 50 millimeter, and let us make the x-axis dimension 100 millimeter. You see, the shape will get automatically the dimensions you have given. A while ago, as we told, you can make ellipses, you can make circles from ellipses. When you draw an ellipse and click on the size icon, you will see x and y axis dimensions. If you want a circle having 100 millimeter diameter, just make two dimensions the same as 100 millimeter. Let us see the next tool, which is the copies tool. This makes an array of some drawings in desired amount. For example, let us resize this and make it 10 millimeter diameter. Let us make this small because we will use these circles in array tool. Select the circle, and now the array tool is active. It is written copies when you hold your mouse on it. Click on it, and it will ask you how many of this shape will be repeated in each row with which space between them. The rows, number of these shapes in one row, let us make this 5, and number of this shape in one column, let us make this 10, and let us give spaces of 1 millimeter for each row and column. Now, when we click on OK, you will see that the circles are formed in this way. They form an array in both directions in the desired numbers, desired repetitions, as we have given before. You can change the spaces between them, because you can enter spaces on this tool, and you can change the numbers in one direction or another. The one next to this array tool is the center to table tool. When you select some drawing and click on center to table, that drawing comes to the center of the table. Let us clean this, erase this, and show what the offset tool makes. To be able to see the function, let us draw a rectangle now, and whilst this rectangle is selected, click on the offset tool. The offset tool asks you the distance of offset, how many millimeters you will offset this shape. For example, let us give 4 millimeters, inner or outer. If you click on outer, the new rectangle that is formed from this one, the new rectangle that is formed from this one will be drawn out of the first one. You see, 4 millimeter, it is offsetted. When you click on empty space, you will see the green one. The green one is the offsetted one, and it is 4 millimeter in the outer direction. Let us select the inner one, black one again by clicking on with the mouse. By the way, let us tell one more thing in here. When you click on one shape by left mouse button, if it is a complete shape, if it is not a combination of some other shapes, it will be selected all. So to select complete shapes, clicking on one side is enough. But it is not a complete shape. You have to select it by picking it, by the taking the pick tool and taking it into a closed area until it selects the shape. Now we selected the inner one, original one, and click offset tool again, and this time offset it into the inside. We selected inner and let us make it 6 mm. When we click OK, you will see that a new one is formed. Click on the empty space, you will see it is also green and it is offsetted inside. Let us select the original one again and offset tool and double outer. Let us select and make it 15 mm. When we make it this, you will see that the original one black is offsetted in both directions with 50 mm. The red ones are the offsetted ones, 15 mm outside and 15 mm inside. When you click on empty space, you see that the green ones are all the offsetted ones and black one is the original one. You can carry any one of these by clicking on them and pushing, pulling.